Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are entering into the new session called Cascading Style Sheets, also called as CSS. Till we learned about HTML, now we are giving more about HTML in Cascading Style Sheets. Okay, so enter the topics are Cascading Style Sheets, what is Cascading Style Sheets, and the features of Cascading Style Sheets, CSS level 1, 2 and 3. Types of CSS, we have three types. One is internal CSS, inline CSS and external CSS. We discuss these three in this video. So initially, Cascading Style Sheets, also called as CSS, CSS enables web authors and programmers to finally tune elements for publishing both online and across several different types of media, including print format. Features: search engine optimization, browser compatibility, appearance, maintenance, bandwidth saving, file size, and tableless layouts. So very clearly, search engine optimization. So using meta tag, we are performing search engine optimization. So that can be happened with this. Browser compatibility means if you take any browser, all the browsers, the output will be same. That is called browser compatibility. And appearance, the appearance look and feel will be changed when compared to normal HTML and HTML with CSS. Next one is maintainability. If you want to change any look and feel, just we change the fields, change the tags, that is enough for maintainability. Bandwidth saving, how the bandwidth changes. Already the CSS are in individual files. We change that files automatically. Only one time we are writing it, when multiple pages we are using it, automatically the bandwidth will be saved. Similarly, file size also saved. Why? Because one time we need to write and multiple times we are using it. Tableless layouts. Previously, we know with the help of the table we can design a website. But without using tables also we can design a website. We learn with the help of divisions. Okay. In future, we are learning about those things. Now, CSS level 1, 2 and 3. There are three levels of CSS. CSS 1 defines basic style functionality with limited font and limited positioning support. CSS level 1 defines basic style functionality with limited font and limited positioning support. CSS level 2 adds Arial properties, paged media and better font and positioning support. Many other properties have been defined as well. As CSS 3 adds presentation style properties, allowing you to effectively build presentations from web documents similar to Microsoft PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so what these levels are? This is the first version is CSS level 1, second version is CSS 2, and third version is CSS 3. Present market is using CSS 3. Now, how we are defining styles? So, selector expression, element property, colon, property values. Element property, property values, so on. How many are we using? We need to do it. So, now, types of CSS. There are three types of CSS. One is inline CSS, second one is internal CSS, and third one is external CSS. So go through inline CSS. An inline style may be used to apply a unique style for a single element. Similarly, an inline style loses many of the advantages of a style sheet by mixing content with presentation. Use this method separate. To use inline styles, add the style attribute to the relevant element. The style attribute can contain any CSS property. Now let us take, so h1 is the tag, we are applying style, color is blue and margin left is 30px. So these two are applied, automatically the reflection will be changed in the output. Okay, the paragraph tag we are not at all altered, so by default styles will be applicable to paragraph tag. Now internal CSS, an internal style sheet may be used if one single page has a unique style. So these things are defined in the head section. So this is the head section, under this styles, and one is the body we are applying for styles, and h1 also we are applying for styles. So whenever we are using body tag, automatically the reflection will be there. Similarly, whenever we are using h1, the changes are reflected. Okay, so this is what exactly they are considering into it. So finally, the last one is external CSS. With an external style sheet, you can change the look of an entire website by changing just one file. Okay, so how we are doing is, we are creating mystyle.css. Here we are defining body as well as the h1. Using the link tag, we call that style sheet and we are using it. That is the way we are calling it. This is little bit difficult, but once it is worked out, if you design 100 pages of the style will be designed 100 pages, all 100 pages are look like same only when we are linking with link relay style sheet type text based CSS arif, we need to give the name of the CSS. Okay, so then whenever we are using body h1, automatically the styles will be reflected in the web pages. Thank you.